Bruce Power is mastering artificial intelligence. Quality workers will now have an automated anomaly detection tool to better define indications of defects within our Unit 3's reactor phase.
The cloud two sheet bores are a very, very critical region of the reactors. The bores allow for a cloud two to seal onto the bore region and therefore prevent the cloud two moderator from coming into the channel. The bores cannot have any scratches on them because that could provide a pathway for leakage. On unit six, it would take a very long time for the inspector to sit down and review the entire video for the bores in order to identify all of the indication and write it on a piece of paper.
We would have to play back the entire 360 inspection video of the lattice tube inspection camera rotating around the bore and then pausing it in between whenever they see an indication and then recording that on record sheets.
We took all of the videos that we grabbed from Unit 6 and reached out to a company called ProLucid in order to use that entire data set and build an AI program that can identify all of the anomalies on the bores and therefore the QC inspectors find out if they're acceptable or if we have to do more bore remediation.
The anomaly detection that we're going to be using in Unit 3 will actually be learning as our quality inspectors review more bore images. Any of the indications that they flag, the AI will then learn and use that as a database for any indication it sees in Unit 4 and subsequent major component replacement units. The ultimate goal is for the anomaly detection with the ProLucid software to identify any kind of defects in our bores automatically.
We're in the middle of our major component replacement. These are demanding projects. The more that we can do to automate some of that work, it frees the engineers up to focus on new issues that come up. When we're bringing this to reactor, it's not just that we've developed this new tool and have a tool that works in the lab, but we've also gone through an extensive process to demonstrate that this tool will do what we need it to do. So that qualification process is also a real key aspect of this tool development.
The start of this project actually goes back to our engagement with the ANRC, which is based out of the University of Strathclyde. They've been working with Bruce Power to see where they could help automate MCR and other inspections. And we started talking about a project working together with ATS to work on automating the overall component inspection.
Within the nuclear industry, it's very, very important that we can show and demonstrate running these projects successfully and that we can learn and continue to improve and get better over time. And this is something that Bruce Power is really leading. Each one of these refurbs that happens, being able to look at it and say, how can we improve? How can we make it safer? How can we make it more efficient, reduce the time like critical path? All these things are so important for the industry and just demonstrating that commitment to excellence. And so as a company where we can come in and be a part of the solution, it's really a fulfilling place to be.
I am very excited to work with the new tooling that we have. It provides a great learning opportunity for everybody involved and also taking the industry to the next level using automated tooling for work.